Yeah, well, yeah, see, they caught me! They caught me, the Internet Service Provider people, they caught me. Oh gosh. there's no winning. Like, what do I do? How do I win, right? Like, they found me, this is them just toying with me. Oh gosh. Okay, well, hopefully this stays and we're back in action. But, oh gosh. Anyway, so I do apologize, guys. I know this is kind of frustrating when these things happen, so. Okay. We will cross our fingers, knock on wood type thing. And just, you know, we'll roll with the punches here. Okay, so this now reconnects, and is essentially what we're after. And this actually looks really cool. Like, it's well hidden in this area. It almost looks like it's intentionally, like, purpose-built here. Now, here is another really big question. Do we take this opportunity to maybe make this into a full-fledged two-lane highway that breaks off over at this interchange, just to make things... I mean, yes, like, why not, right? Like, sure. But then we're neglecting this. What if we do another interchange? Well, why not? We're on a roll here. Let's do it. Let us do it. Why the heck not? Okay, so this, I mean, it served its purpose again. We just need something now that does, I think, a little bit higher volume. So maybe we can just erase that altogether. Cool. Back in business. Merge from the two-lane? Yeah, I think that's probably the best way. I think we're going to maybe split this into the three-laner highway kind of thing. Make that happen. So three lanes gets condensed down to two lanes, and then that kind of, you know, does its own little thing that way. Okay, this will be kind of fun, I think. So why don't we do the inside first, because that might be a little bit easier to follow. And we could just very simply go at it like this. Keep it that kind of height. That's fine, I think, for the bridge. Let's look at our pre-made intersections. And, what is this, sour, please? What's going on here? Better play than the, Oh, yeah, well, I mean internet, right? Yeah, of course. Definitely better internet in the EU. Unfortunately, we just don't have that many options in Canada. And it's one of those things, it's like, they can kind of do whatever they want. It's just like, you know, again, I have no other option, right? What am I going to go to the competition? No, they're just as bad. See you later. Thanks for stopping by. Okay, what am I looking for here? Just an interchange, I guess, right? Nothing too hectic. Hopefully one that's a little bit compact, even. You know, we could do a trumpet in here if we make it a little bit compact, right? Because that could merge in there, and then the trumpet part could be the exit. Or we can have the trumpet facing the other way. Options. It might be a little bit too big, though. And I don't really want to destroy all of this stuff per se again, I don't think. Actually, you know what we could do, just super, super quick, is since this is already partially buried, we can just bury this the rest of the way over here. Take that. Take this. Take that, you fool! Go down by 12. And, oh, right, that's why I didn't go the whole way, because that thing is in the way. Oh. Oh, well, what if we got rid of this instead? Okay, so we know this comes from down here. We'll just need a different, so I guess we'll bridge this instead of tunneling it. So we'll just be aware of that. We have no way in with trams just yet. And so we'll rezone over here. It looks like it already is, no problem. Okay. Now, do we have the room for this? Kind of. Sort of, actually. Okay, we can probably actually remove this. I think we have some flexibility with how these two can kind of connect. So maybe... like, maybe something like this isn't out of the question, to be honest with you. Especially if it's, like, a little bit over the river. Oh, this could be, like, all kinds of sexy. Hey there, tracking, what's going on? Thanks for stopping by. Hope this Sunday is treating you well. Okay. I think, honestly, I think we're onto something here, guys. I think. Okay, so where do we have to go? Just over here, right? Maybe. Oh, boy. How do we get these guys to connect without them looking too chaotic? I think the answer is to follow the bank a little bit like this. Yeah, that's a nice little gentle bend. I think we can do that. Oh man, this is so cool! And look, people are using this! And like, traffic is not, like, terrible here. Oh, and the traffic light, that works too. Oh, that's cool. So since we're doing traffic light, what I'd like to do now instead is open this up with a wider... That's two lanes right there. Yeah, that's a bit better, I think. And you know, maybe we can just get rid of that altogether. Just free up some of the traffic on that bridge. Yeah, sure, why not? And then by that same argument, we can do this because we have the traffic light here kind of governing things. And that's almost the bypass here instead of having to do that. Oh, well, this is cool. I like it. Oh, you know what we could even do? Oh, man. All right. Now we're putting our thinking hats on, friends. Look at this. You guys ready to get your minds blown? Look at this. Something like this, huh? There we go. How about that? And because it's going to be really noisy, we will make these guys into commerciale. Cool. Oh, it's so delicious. I love it. Isn't that so nice? I think we'll do this. Very cool. And then we could probably put some trees or, you know, whatever, just in here. Which we probably won't do now. Let's go back to this spot here. Let's connect our links, or link our highways back up. Oh no, the frames, they are starting to drop. No, you see, I told you, the internet people, they found me. They know what I'm up to. No, it's no good. Oh boy. I honestly don't know why. It's like my internet service provider. They just don't, I don't know, like I pay for unlimited internet and they're like, well, you pay for it, but we don't really want to give it to you, so we'll throttle your connection and hope you'll give up streaming or whatever, right? Because when I call them, they have like nothing to say. They're like, oh yeah, we noticed your connection is a little erratic, sir. We'll restart it on our end and everything should be okay. And I'm like, okay. And then it lasts, you know, until I start doing anything that's like extraordinarily internet intensive, and then I call them and it's the same old story. They're like, well, you need to try to restart your router. And I'm like, I have. And I'm like, okay. Maybe we'll restart on our end. I'm like, okay. You know, it just feels like you go nowhere, right? Okay. This is cool. Like I'm really digging this. And like look at how much faster traffic can move through here. And like look at how much cooler it looks too versus the other one, right? Oh, Eric! Yes, yo, I'll play some DayZ later tonight if you want. I would totally do that. Oh, you're allowed to yell in here. It's okay, don't worry. Okay. So yeah, I do apologize for the drop frames here, guys. Hopefully, it's not gonna be too bad. Okay, so what we're doing here is we're merging from this point onto our highway. And it would be kind of cool if we could make this work. Like, you know, symmetrically, or just make it look kind of a little bit nicer than the way we have it. So that can go like this, and then that can go. Okay, so what if we go by two lanes here, and that'll just open up, say right there. Yeah, that's kind of better. And then this is where you want to make sure that your turning lanes aren't being like ridiculously dumb. So we'll change these around right here, so only able to turn right. Cool. And that should hopefully... Yeah, that's definitely it. Oh man, this is awesome! Guys, look at this! This is great. This is cool. And so, this will now merge in with a new road that we're gonna bring up and over, and that'll be the kind of interchange or whatever just for this this spot here. And it looks like we might have to do some demolition just to get one of these roads kind of kind of working in our favor here, which is, it's no problem. It's just going to take us a little bit of planning, that's all. Okay, so who's got roots on what? Right, that's where that guy does that old loop-de-loop right there. What city is this? Oh, this is a separate city we're doing just for the live streams. You can kind of see all the poor people that had to drive through here since that interchange is taken out. So yeah, this is something we're totally, totally different, eh? Look at this. Cool, huh? I like it. Kind of fun. I'm missing a rail section? Oh, thank you. Oh, did I not reconnect? I don't think you're right. You're right, I did not. Appreciate that. Yep, there we are. Cool, that'll help with the traffic too. Okay, so until we reconnect this with this, unfortunately all the highway traffic's going through this interchange, so that's really inefficient. Okay, so I'm gonna pause it, so we may be disturbing one of our transit lines right here. So I'm gonna remove this. And so what I'm gonna instead do is have tram tracks. Have this one come over as a bridge. Or you know what we probably should do is a tunnel. Because I think we're... Oh no, right, we can't do the tunnel because of that. Right. Okay, so up to 12, just to give us a little bit more height here. Okay, that's... I think nice and straight, right? That's relatively... Yeah, that's what we're after. Another one when I destroyed that tunnel. Oh, is that not the... Wait, which one am I missing here now? Yeah, so this one should be connected, right? Like, really, see, that one goes the whole way through. That one had nowhere else to go, right? And then, where was the other one I'm missing here? No, that should be it, right? Or it's... Oh, yes, I see what you mean. This seems to go, yes. Okay. So, this will have to be... I guess connecting, figure out a connection point to that. Oh boy. So that could probably go. Oh my goodness, so much to consider with that. Well, you know, let's do this first, and then we'll figure that out after. One thing at a time here. But don't let me forget about that, boys and girls. Okay. And so this will now go like this, I think. Doing my best to get that lined up. Let's take off our collision and our zoning. Actually, what we could do, we'll keep that on. Let me just take off the, I don't know what that defaults. Sodium vapor. Is that what the default? Okay. I want that off. There we go. So that goes over to here. Pillars go back on. And then that connects to that. Excellent. Getting there. Alright, now, this rail, I think the best way for that to come in is to go underneath here. Which means you're going to be ground level going like this, right next to the highway, which will look really, really cool. Okay, so that's not going to work because of that pillar, of course, right there, right? Of course. Darn it, too bad that can't work. Wait, can it? Oh wait, no, almost, darn it. Sometimes you just can't win, can you? Okay, so I'm gonna remove this part here in terms of a pillar, just to make that a little bit easier here. Wait, what did you guys do with Reddit here? Oh, you did it, Reddit. Oh, well, you're pointing out. Okay, I gotcha. I'm just slow to read the comments. You guys are pointing out what I already know. Okay, so pillar off, and then this goes straight. About there, and then we start our little curvy adventure. Perfect, and we got no pillars there now. Excellent. We do want a pillar right here though, so I'm gonna put in, see if I can actually do that. Should be able to. Yeah. Oh wait, I didn't put the pillar back in. Darn it. No, almost foiled. I want some pillars just for like a little bit of realism. There we go. Yes, that took forever to do, but worth it. Oh, I know. I saw the GTX 1080. It is out. It is sold out everywhere as well, though. That's the other thing you forgot to mention. Not only that, it's really expensive. Like, people are, like, over, they're selling it for, like, too much or whatever. That's the word I'm looking for here, like, overvaluing it, I guess. But I don't know what to do. I'm either going to get a 1080, or I'm going to get a GTX 980. Because the current 960 that I have, it's fantastic, it's just not enough. So it's going to have to, unfortunately, be replaced. And then this will just go in like that. Oh, I love that. That's such a nice little, you know, kind of works with that little bend right there kind of thing. Okay, now this will just swing over here. And I'm going to go a little bit further straight. And then that will go. Come on now. I know you want to. Please come, talk to your friend. Tell him all the great things that's happening over on this side of the world. Almost, we're so close here. Okay, so go up at 12, and it just... That's it.
That's it. That is it.
Oh, such a weirdo. Yeah, isn't that gorgeous? I love it. Perfect. Still gotta figure out what we're doing with this road, but... Oh wait, no, not gorgeous, because that's a little bit of a weird... We can change this sometimes. Okay, so that kind of connects rather nicely, I think. There we go. Get rid of all these trees that have a mind of their own right here. Okay. The little details. It's all about the little details sometimes. So that kind of connects rather nicely, I think. Now, we've lost, unfortunately, this thing here, right? Can we save it? Like, where does this one even go? What line is that? So whenever I'm lost on a line like this, see how it's all the same line connected? I'm just going to change the color. Because, you know, the rest of our lines are all the same color, right? So now we can see where it goes. Ah, so it's that one. So, you know, what we can do is delete it and maybe extend it further down or something. Or just redo it a little bit differently. Okay, so let's do that. Yes, please. Auf Wiedersehen, my friends. Okay. So, we're just gonna need a new line to kinda, you know, fit through this little quadrant. So let's look at the rest of them. I mean, we're already getting pretty good coverage. Arguably, we don't even really need one until we kinda maybe figure out this side anyhow. So I think we just kinda leave it as it is. Okay, so I'm gonna put 3-speed back on, just so we're not really losing too much of our money or anything here as we're working along. And we're just gonna have to find a way to make, you know, maybe this road connect with the highway or just something kind of work. We gotta get traffic out of this area here. Holy smokes! Alright, now, who are we gonna be going symmetrically with here? I think we're gonna maybe use the slope of the terrain here as kind of our guide. So I think we're going to go, say, like this. And then this is going to link up with this. And that hopefully will work with our slope. Oh, yeah, not bad for a little guess right there in terms of the height. Okay, so let's do that. And then we can do something similar with what we did, I don't even know where that was, under the bridge. Over here, see how we have like the highway in two different spots? And oh, this is starting to get a little bit backed up. So I guess we really do need that extra interchange over here working. Okay, so this can be... go a little bit straight with this. And unfortunately, the pillars are gonna be... Oh, actually, it's not so bad. It's saying that is ground level, which is interesting. And I'm gonna bring this up to 12 because that's the height we used for the other one. And I think if I go straight at this point, that's fine to connect there. And then just to space these out, maybe we can have that one come from, say, like over here and then just kind of go down the hill a bit. Say something like this, for example. If this feels like cooperating. Oh, it does too. Okay, cool. And then this valley can just, you know, be trees or rocks or whatever, right? Just because it's a kind of a unique shape. It's actually pretty hilly over here too. But now we've got another link, so we should hopefully see a reduction in traffic going through both of these spots here. It's just that bridge, you know, I mean, it might be a little bit out of the way, so we'll kind of see if it actually makes an impact or not. But something that we could do, just to encourage more people using this, is say having this as a way down right here. If this will cooperate. It will. I'm going to change the slope in just one second. I want this here first. There we go. And then that will now go like this. Oh, it's 13 units? Oh, darn it, of course. Well, let's see if we can get that to go just ever so slightly closer. Now that we know that, at least. I should put an observatory up there. Actually, that's a pretty good suggestion. Oh my goodness, you guys have so much. Yeah, I mean, I still, you can kind of, I really am stuck. I mean, like in terms of my other parts, right? Like, I already have, like, I have an i7, I have a 4790, 24 gigs of RAM. So, really, the only thing holding me back is. Oh, it's still 13. Oh, darn, I made that longer. Is video card. You have an i5 for a 750 Ti. Oh, that's an older card. I had, before this, I had a 650 Ti, I think is what it was, and then I had a 760, and then I went from a 760 to a 960, and now I'm just kind of, you know, torn on what to do here. Go to the a 980 or a 1080. I'm not really getting what I'm looking for here, guys. I want just kind of a nice gentle downward slope here. This game is being very finicky. Okay, so we'll go 12 units. Let's bring this down to ground level. There, I think that's probably the best approach. My best piece of advice, though, is whatever parts you're deciding on getting, like, you know, wait even the extra 2-3 weeks or months even just to get one step up a little bit better. Because you're going to have your computer arguably for a long time, like hopefully for a long time. I personally think the more money you spend initially, the less you have to spend on upgrades, so it is kind of worth it, I think, to do, you know, just a little bit more investment in the beginning, but to each their own. But just, you know, my cup of tea there. Yeah, the 980 GTA, yeah, it's a good card. Even the 980 just base one. I think I would get a bare minimum a 980 Ti. I'm just really about 100% yet. I still have to see how the prices kind of settle, because they are a little bit more expensive in Canada just anyway. Unfortunately. It looks like we're actually having some issue with services over in this side of the world right here. Specifically garbage collection, so maybe we can put a recycling facility in over here. Kind of hide that right there. It's kind of cool next to the rails as well. You know, let's stretch the profile of some of these industries out a little bit further so they kind of meet up with the rail right there. And maybe we can build a little something back here too. Not quite. Oh, that'd be so cool if that fit. Why won't that go? Tell me why not. Is it too high? Oh, it is probably. No, wait, that's not true. What is it? Okay, that's so strange. I'm doing that though. I like that. Just getting rid of these extra trees. Put it back to one speed. I guess we really don't have to be going that fast anymore. Cool. And this can kind of connect over here. Eric, you're the best. So yeah, Eric, I'm legit. I'll play some DayZ later tonight if you want. I actually haven't even upgraded to 0.60. Like, last I heard, like, it was having a little bit of troubles. Yeah, that's kind of neat. And then we can probably get a road going in here as well. Oh, we can even do that. Oh, interesting. Let's double up those lanes. Weird. Do I like this? I don't know. See how that kind of turns out. Interesting. It didn't really give us a little bit more area to work with, though, so maybe we can sneak someone else back through here. Oh, yeah, just through the center of that street. We could do that, right? Yeah, just like a little side option right there. Okay, so just something to get some more zoning squares in and around this area. It's cool. I mean, people are using this interchange, just not really as much as I thought they would. So you can kind of see we're still getting a little bit too much volume through everywhere else. 750 Ti, because you have the old PC at quad core. Bottom dart. Oh, cities and Fallout 4. 16 gigs of RAM is usually enough. I find i5, I used to have an i5. I went from an i5 to an i7, and I thought the i5 was enough. And then when I started moving, using the i7, holy smokes, what a difference it actually makes. And I mean, you don't really have to get, because like when I went to get my i7, they were saying that the 4790 is enough. You don't really have to get the 6000 one, like the 6K or whatever. It's like an extra like 200 bucks or whatever. Oh my goodness, celebrity status, what is going on? Mr. Yorkshire Gamer, what a pleasant surprise, sir. How are you doing? Long time no see, man. Glad you're stopping by. As you can probably guess, I'm trying to stream, you know, a little bit more often these days, so. Oh, you know what we could do now, guys, actually? Just to kind of make things go a little bit full circle here, and that is a little bit of a road pun. Let's connect these all up. And that gets people kind of sharing this a little bit more, I think. Oh, you know what? Oh, right, that won't be a traffic light, because that's the intake, so that's okay. I'm going to double up this road here, though. Oh, and of course I can't. Okay, we can do that. Get rid of these extra... perfects. He is that guy from that thing, you're absolutely right. Well, it's a little bit on hold, I think, at the moment, but he was making YouTube videos for a while. Kept us all entertained. Our good friend Matt from the UK. Hey there, Dave, what's going on? Happy Sunday. Okay, so this is now starting to get a little bit more traffic through here, i.e. one or two cars, which is, you know, a step in the right direction. We can maybe open that up to wider traffic too. And then the other option now is to connect these, like, you know, have a little exit coming from this little interchange. Because why not, right? Something like this. That we could do. And that's only going to be an exit from that side. And then we can maybe do... No, that's fine, having the on-ramp right here. I was going to say maybe an on-ramp kind of going... I mean, I don't know. Maybe we still can. Just something like this, right? So go up to 9. Just come across like that. Does that look really crazy? Nah, not really. I don't know. I don't know if that ruins things or not. Let me try that a little bit differently here. Yeah, okay. I think, you know, the idea is kind of there. Okay, so we'll just bring that down a little bit. Yeah, I think that's a little bit better. This kind of matches the profile, I think, of the other ones a little bit better. There we go. Oh, that's kind of cool. Just get more people cycling through instead of using the other interchanges. Okay. And speaking of allergies, my nose is suddenly becoming very stuffed up, so I apologize if I start sniffling a little bit here, guys. There's a storm that is, like, fast approaching, and I can feel the clouds above me, which is, like, the worst feeling for pressure in your head. But I'll survive. Okay, cool. I'm really digging this. We're like really, really, really moving up in terms of infrastructure. Like, it's some heavy infrastructure here now. And these slopes, not too crazy. Maybe not the cleanest per se, so maybe we can try that again. Okay. Oh, we were using a two-lane road, that's correct. And then maybe we can drop that down to, a six, and then... Yeah, that's a little bit better, right? Not really. I mean, sort of is, right? Let me try that again. Yeah, I mean, this is kind of the angle. Oh, but then we're left with that same... I see the same issue. Alright, well, we'll just do our best. So we'll take off the snappers. Just go like this to say... Ooh, three. And then... There we go. A little bit smoother. I'll take that. A little bit more we're after. Okay, I'm gonna put on three speed. I just wanna see traffic now. I just wanna see what happens. Oh, I'm such a sucker for storms. Holy smokes, I am such a sucker for storms. Actually, I don't know, some of you may not have even seen this. I have a really old, so I can track it down. I have an old YouTube video that I took, and it's just me taking some slow motion of some lightning. So I'm like out in a park or whatever. It's like regular speed, and afterwards it's some slow motion. Let me link you the video here. This is so random. If you guys are maybe into some lightning, you guys can check that out. No storms in the Midlands now? So yeah, you gotta be kind of like, we're at the north end of Tornado Alley, sort of, technically. So we sometimes, you know, get a few tornadoes. Not that often, but... Now, I wonder if we're doing too much over here in terms of traffic. I wonder if we should make this a... We don't have the bypass otherwise. I almost want to add like an extra lane to this thing. Make this like a six-lane road, just that one little stretch here. This means we have to move this church. Okay, so I'll put the church down here. If it's it'll cooperate with us. Well, apparently it won't. Oh, a wise guy, huh? Okay, well the church is going over here because it's being uncooperative. Yeah, I suck at, actually, I don't know if I suck at Rocket League or not, because I've actually never tried it. I feel really bad, because my friend gifted it to me for Christmas, but I still have not played it yet. That's so bad of me. Okay, so we're adding one extra lane here, which will allow people to queue up and turn a little more effectively. And if we change our lane arrows, make the center one go both ways, that should hopefully help people waiting right here. I don't want to see too much of a line. That's a little bit better, I think. And then you can see now that more people are using over here, if it's really not that many, it frees up volume from this interchange, it frees up volume over here, right? So I think we've got a win on our hands here. Kind of hopping back and forth between three speed and whatnot. Okay, so services and stuff, we definitely need to get some of those over here. Get some more music going. Yeah, Toronto weather is definitely crazy. Like, some days when I'm recording, you can hear, like, thunder in the background type thing. It's like, even today, like, our humidity level is absolutely bonkers. Like, with the humidity, at the peak this afternoon, it was 37 degrees Celsius. Which is absolutely ridiculous. And that's for Canada. Yeah, Jean Grey, you're absolutely right. We did actually get a pretty legit winter this year. Not like the ice storm of a few years back, though, but... Yeah, has it snow in Toronto with 35-degree weather? It doesn't snow in the summertime, silly. It only snows, like, periodically, right? No, well, sometimes... I won't lie. We'll sometimes actually have snow in May, which is, like, the scariest, weirdest thing when that actually happens, but... Luckily, it's fairly, like, a rare occurrence, so... Don't gotta worry too much about that. Okay, so let's meet some of our office demand. And then maybe some commercial demand, too. Just to get some more money and get some more people going. And I'm hopefully trying to get more people using this interchange just so I can kind of see how it's doing for flow. So far, so good, though. And we can even do another connection thing, say, over here before that that tunnel. There are lots of options. All right. Coming together. It is not always snow in Canada. There is always snow in Canada, though. It depends on what part of Canada you go to. You have to go really far north, though, to find snow this time of year. But no, Canada, or Toronto, I should say, it's like you know, South America weather. So people who are here visiting from South America, they always comment about how the weather feels just like they're back home, and they're like, it's a pleasant surprise for them. Because today, I mean, it is really hot. I am not lying. Like, that is like 37 degrees Celsius. That is hot. Okay, so once upon a time, we said we wanted to build some foothill, little suburb kind of community over here. That fell apart. That was so long ago. Okay, let's try that again. Okay, so let's do some of these windy roads, say, attached to this. And let's try and follow, I guess, kind of the same kind of bend and shape, more or less. And then this is where we're going to do our zoning, just based off of these roads here. That's a little bit steep, so that might be kind of the border to what we'll allow. And this one just connects over here. I'm not going to keep that, because that is horrifyingly steep. That's, like, so silly. We can just maybe stay this high up, though, as an option. Something like that. Ooh, that's not too bad, eh? Like the idea of this. Yeah, that's it. And so we could probably find a way to get these to now connect, which will be pretty convenient. I would also like just one more little connection point from here, just upward or something. Okay, let's find a way. Ooh, that might be it. Yes, sir, I think we got it. Not quite, we're almost there. Okay, so let's move this a little bit further. And then, I think we'll have to terraform, to be honest, over here. Trying to avoid having to do that, but, you know, can't quite make it happen. And my poor nose is all stuffed up. I have this feeling like where I need to sneeze, you know how that kind of happens? But I don't think I'm quite there yet, so if I suddenly just, like, brain fart and sneeze, you know what's happening. It is the allergies. Okay, that's better. That kind of gives traffic, you know, two ways to get up here. Yeah, that's better. Okay, so we'll see what we can just get in terms of, take us some houses here. I'm not gonna zone the whole thing. Maybe a couple little patches. Just kind of see how this turns out. Actually, you know what? I take that back. Let's put commercial over here. Okay, so we'll just do some zoning. Look at that, people are already moving in. Oh, the 2012 flooding? Yeah, definitely. Yeah, I mean, even, like, every summer it just seems like, or not even summer, just like year-round, it just seems like there's more and more just global, just weather phenomenon happening. And like, every year it's just like some record-breaking flood, some record-breaking earthquake, just a huge tornado. So it's pretty wild. Global warming, definitely a real thing. Okay, we got pipes in here? A little bit. Not a huge amount. And we might maybe need to bring in some power lines, but we'll see if the buildings will be able to stretch the power themselves. No, it doesn't quite look like it. Okay, so we'll just put in a utility box or like an antenna or something. Or both. And find somewhere where this slope isn't too steep. There we go. That's now that connected. That works for me. Oh, even like 2 weeks away from this game feels like a lifetime. I can't even imagine not playing for 2 months. Yeah, you've been a busy guy, man. I haven't heard from you in a while. And my heart broke when you had your channel disappeared. I was like, no, what happened to him, you know? I'm glad you're well, though. I really like this little lake. I'm going to put someone else in here, too. Remember we talked about that a little while ago. What's a cool water thing? Fishing tour, not quite. We could do a little marina in here. That's a cute idea. Oh, yeah, look at that. Oh, that's so nice. I like that. There. And maybe one more thing, just for funsies. Oh, I forgot that we have these. Oh, yes. Oh, my goodness. So many memories now coming back to me. Restaurant beer? Sure. That might be getting a little bit busy, but let's do that. Okay, now I would like a little bit of high density just kind of in this little part right here. That'll look kind of cool. Okay. And now, if we do this properly, we can also bring this road up and connect. Just to kind of give us her a little bit more options. Nope, too steep. Worried about that. Almost had it. Oh, hey, hello. Well, hello there. Oh, that's perfect. Yeah, that's not too steep. We can do that. Okay. And then these can probably connect as well. That shouldn't be too hard to do. There, look at that. So we'll put some high density in here. Same with down here. There we go, just mix that up. Probably need a little bit more shopping. Oh, and what we should probably do is put a train station. I think we talked about doing that. Oh yeah, that's right, before the internet problems at the last stream, and we were working on this little thing here. Oh yes, it is all coming back to me. Sassy UK, what's going on? 780 TIs being sold. Ooh, that's expensive. Yeah, there's such a push for new video cards right now. Like, really, you just wait a few weeks, right? They'll all just go back on, you know, regular pricing. Okay, so it's all coming back to me now. So that'll go like this. Get a small train station over here. So put that right there. Oh, cool. And that'll just connect over here. Now, is this our internal line? It is. Oh, cool and convenient. How wonderful. Okay. Now, I'd like this to go, I guess, straight-ish. Oh, yeah, that's it. Okay, now, are we gonna do a bypass? I think we can add one afterwards if we need to, but there shouldn't be too much traffic going through here. So I think that's fine as it is. Should work for me. Okay. So power, not a whole heck of a lot of it coming over this way. And I think we're gonna have to do, yeah, something like this. Cool, that looks kinda nice. Oh wait. Oh, that does connect. Oh, that is, I don't know why, but that just for some reason is amazing. Okay, that's too steep, but I like the idea at least. Maybe the curve. No! Oh my gosh, it was still way too steep. No way. Okay, let's try that with a tunnel. Yep, there we go. Nope, that's not it. Almost, though. Can't see the idea, at least, right? The 1070? Yeah, that should be definitely as good at around the Titan. I mean, it's just it's crazy how good cards are getting. Oh, and who is this guy over here? Oh, right, we have that train still gotta figure out. Right. I was saying in a previous stream, it's just, you know, even in the last few years, it's really nice to see that gaming computers, they're moving at such a fun pace. So, like, you know, almost every few months you're getting a better video card. So, like, the secondary market is getting flooded with, like, even better parts. So, it's kind of making PC gaming a little bit more, you know, you can kind of buy a really good computer that's secondhand for not too expensive these days. So it's making it a lot more attainable to more and more people, which I think is really great. Okay, so these now connect. I think it would be beneficial to have, even if it's like a level crossing, just one more crossing happening here. I'll make this all connect so it works properly, just in terms of the old flow and visuals. Let's do that. Put in some high densities, put in some commercial right here. This will be pretty noisy, right? So, probably better as commercial. Commercial. Cool. Also cool. Nice. Okay, now what line? Do we have that line that goes... We do, we can replace that now. Delete this. Create ourselves a new line, and this one will go from our new train station down to our industrial area. Oops, I went too far. There you are. So we're starting here. Go on over here. Stopping there. And where are we going? Industry. There we are. Back that up. And so this is an internal train line. So it doesn't connect to the regional train tracks. So we don't have to worry about too much train traffic. And that was a black train fleet. So we'll make that one black as well. Cool. And I'm digging these high density buildings coming in. Yes. Look at this. Strong man. Hoo-hoo-hoo, loving that. Very good, right? Hey, what's going on there, Yov? Hope you're having a good night. Alright, let's put in some services over here, guys. There's a school. Probably use a high school as well. I really like this building. I just don't think it's gonna fit. Hold the phone. Yes! Bite your tongue. Alright. Okay, can we make maybe a little bit more room up here? I think we can, by George. Why, yes, look at this. Open this right up. Cool, look at that. Nice. Alright. So this will just go like this. All I'm doing is just making a little side street here for some more zoning. Same with on this side here. Okay, so this was commercial, and the reasoning for that was because we're getting closer to the noise and some of that pollution. And then this will be residential. Cool. A little tour? Yeah, totally. No problem at all. Let's take a little peek around. It's actually a fairly big city these days. We really haven't figured out, per se, where the downtown is going to be. So this is almost like a starter part of the city. And the more it grows, the more I kind of see it actually just being one giant kind of interconnected thing. But for the moment, what we have here is a university campus, just on this little island right down there, which is kind of fun. Nice big kind of library building. Our bus stop, which unfortunately is not being used right now, but it will be eventually. Got some tram tracks that go through here as well. And across the street, we got some government buildings, a lot of parkings, like our courthouse. We have the CN Tower, just for fun. This is Skydome / Rogers Center. It's gonna be a sports facility. In real life, we have baseball games here. And concerts and stuff actually happen at the Rogers Center. And then just a little bit of a kind of office-y kind of condo district over here, some in-town suburbs, a little amusement park here on the waterfront. This was kind of cute. And this might maybe get added to. We might maybe get some more assets going for that eventually. It's kind of fun. And then this is the starting of a beach, but we might maybe take this out and move it somewhere else and just kind of keep the arch here is kind of like our, you know, 4 point for the city. But it's kind of cool. If you look at the city this way, you get the CN Tower, you get a good view of that really wherever you are in the city. Hey, simply press start. What's going on? And then over here, we got a fun little island with the Statue of Liberty on it. And in case you're a tourist and you're not driving, we've got tram access, this little underground tunnel right here. And that comes out right over there, which is kind of cool. Because these are services that enter there. And then we got a little back access to our highway. No one's really using this just yet, but the options are there for, you know, for some future growth. And then over here, just a little, you know, more or less some residential zones. Kind of see just in terms of our zoning, most of this is you know, offices mixed in with some commercial, a little bit industry over here, some industry down at the harbor, but mostly what I'm going for is just some, you know, suburbs kind of in town kind of feel with a little bit of low density. We actually don't have an airport just yet. I don't even think we've unlocked it, to be honest. We're actually a pretty small city, all things considering. And then yeah, we have a cool highway that kind of stretches through. We're doing some custom interchanges just on our own right here, and I eventually want to fill them in with like rocks and trees just to add a little bit more just kind of realism and kind of fun. So hopefully we'll see this pop up a little more often. We have this really, really, really cool kind of like bike autobahn, kind of like, you know, lakeshore kind of bike highway. It has just a few random on and off points too, which is kind of neat. So, and I wish that grass didn't kind of bump through, and I wish, you know, it looked a little bit more even Steven and stuff, but we tried. We might maybe do a little bit of a better job with that, but the idea is pretty cool, and luckily it's pretty popular too. And so we do have a few in-town bike networks, but something we definitely have to, I think, work on. Needs more moistness. You guys, you know I love that word. Don't do it. And something that we also made that I think is really cool in this city is we have a, it's kind of like a magic roundabout. And a YouTuber, YouTube channel is called Squirrel Army Studios, came up with this idea. Let's bring the sun back up. And this is actually a real thing. It's in the UK, I think in two cities they have it. And it's just a series of roundabouts around a central one. And we did something kind of fun and put a tram through here, so this is kind of cool. We're slowly building a you know, little city around there, more or less. And then just for this stream, what we've been doing is just we built this right at the very beginning. This little utilities facility up here with a few offices and like some services, that kind of stuff. This is really cool. I really like this, to be honest. And now we're starting to do a little suburb in the foothills right here. Probably need some more services. Trying to do some high density down here. Get some houses up there. And we just put this into, yeah. Look at this nice pretty train station. People are using it. Look at that. Excellent. And here it comes right here. Oh, look at that. Oh, it's the Toronto subway. Oh, how lovely. Custom assets. Tim Hortons, too. Look at these custom assets. It's like a little piece of Canada right here. Love it. These are actually the new subway trains we're using in Toronto. That's a custom train asset right here. Very fun. I like this, guys. Oh, we got ourselves a fire right here. But no, it's a cool city. Like, every city I try to make it a little bit different than the last one. Or the other ones, right? And I think mission accomplished with this. And we still have this really fun lake. This is Swimming Duck Lake right here, actually. Named after you, Swimming Duck! And we still gotta do some fun stuff over here. Actually, why don't we put someone in right now, speaking of which? Okay, so we definitely want, yeah, jet skis. Yeah, fun! Okay, so we're going to need a path coming down here so people can access this. Okay, so let's get that as close as we can. Yes! Okay, let's go like that. and go like this. There we go. And we're gonna make that little part a little bit smoother, so we'll change that. But at least we know what we're after. Oh, you know, it'd be so cool if that was like a perfect straight line, but nope, that's okay though. Oh, an asterisk, look at how busy this is. Yeah, if it'll reconnect, hopefully. I always get nervous when these things hover for a little bit too long. There we go. Okay, so, jet ski. Put our restaurant in. Is that the restaurant? That's what the restaurant is, right? Oh, it's a fishing pier. Oh, cool. Fishing tour. Okay, so I'm actually going to move that one slightly over here. Yeah, those two can kind of team up a little bit. Or even better, is if this goes in the middle. Ooh, but then, wait, how do you get to that side? You wouldn't be able to. So this has to move again. And foiled by my own intricacies here. There we go, that's better. Okay, that's working. You like it? Oh, you love your Lego. I'm glad you like that. And I'm gonna name some more places after some more of you guys too. Swimming deck just happens to be the first one. Okay, so we need marina. And is that connected? I hope so. Looks like it's close enough. I think we might maybe see some cars try to float in between the two, but oh well. Okay. Oh, beach volleyball. Oh, fun stuff. Oh, we should do, yeah, we should do a few more random things over here. Get a skate park in here too? Yeah. Oh, yeah, this is a cool little spot now. Oh, and you know what we should do is I have, you know, like a public restroom, like those kind of things, right? Maybe we can do some parking too. Okay, that makes sense to me. There's a washroom right here. Washroom or restroom or toilets, whatever you guys use for, you know, however you pronounce it. I think it's funny that we live in a world where, like, that kind of stuff happens, you know? Or, like, subway, metro, you know, tram, streetcar, like, that kind of stuff, right? A lot of interchangeable words, just for even city words, right? I'm looking for just a small parking lot to use here. I've had coffee this whole time. I've had maybe this much of it. I'm just sitting here getting cold on my desk, as always. Of course. The Witcher 3 swimming duck hunt? Oh, my goodness. Oh, we can fit a parking lot in here. Cool. Oh, and then that actually looks really cool the way it kind of moves. I wish the terrain was a little bit more flat, but I like the way those kind of work next to each other. Alright, cross your fingers that we can get that. Yeah, there it is. Beautiful. I'll let that be in the end there. That's fine. Oh, this is so cool. Honestly, I'm having like way too much fun with the city, guys. And it's all about the little things too. That really is nice, isn't it? It's just like a little something. That's all we really needed. Maybe we can get some more zoning like that. How absolutely quaint. And then maybe we can get a couple like boardwalk style shops or whatever to fill in right there. Oh, and then are we stretching our luck if we try and put an actual boardwalk in here? I have a feeling that we might be. So this might not actually work here, but... like something like this, right? Can't be built on water, huh? Alright. I see. Nope. We were too close to the water. Yeah. Oh well. No, give me one spot. No. Oh well. Okay. I won't let it jab us. Oh, am I glitching in shadows here? I always get nervous because the time warp mod, that one still has some compatibility issues. So sometimes I have to restart the game just to kind of get that fixed. This is like, it really is cool having this many train tracks going through here. And I like the fact there's still a little bit of an industrial kind of feel. Okay, can these roads reconnect or what was the story with these guys here? I think they probably can, but probably have to go underground. Oh, there's a police station there. Je comprends. Okay, so let's move that over. Can we... Can I make this work without destroying too much? Alright, well... Yes. Yes, 9 units. I need 12 units, preferably, here. There we go. Oh, actually, that works, too. Oh, actually, that does work. Works rather well. Alright. So, this... fills in with that. More industry. Just a hint of it. I know we're really close to our people right here, but I just want to see a little bit more. Just ever so slightly. And am I crazy to think that we might be able to get something through here? There. Can that... is there a pillar? There is. There is indeed. Well, I mean, I guess we could put some trees just over in this spot right here. I don't really like having too much open space. It's just, you know, I mean, this really, it should be a little bit more industrial kind of feel though, shouldn't it? Almost like we should be using some of the ground textures. To be honest though, I think I removed them all. What are these things here? Just, yeah, ground decals? Yeah, I think I removed all the... Oh, I still have all these ones. Those are all single ones, though. Like, I took out, you know, hundreds, literally hundreds of mods and assets, guys. Like, majority of the assets. I really wouldn't say too many mods, actually. My ground brush painter, like, that kind of stuff is gonzo. And I know there's a new one in the workshop, so I'm gonna try maybe playing around with some new, assets, or like some more important ones, I should say. And now that I see this, I'm actually going to make that line up with this. There, it's a little, I mean, still a little bit crooked, but that's better. Yeah, I mean, whatever, that's not the end of the world. What am I saying? Let's fix this. I can't do it. Oh, and I wish that lined up with that. That'd be so cool. Darn it. Okay. There's that. And that is that. Ooh, that's nice. And then I think we may have gone the wrong angle on this just slightly. Unless we go like that and fix it. Oh, it might maybe be the... You know, you can tell it's a little bit crooked, but maybe that can be fixed here. Yeah, I mean a little bit. I'll just leave it. Otherwise, I get too finicky when it comes to that kind of stuff. What am I doing? I'm being all... I'm nitpicky, that's what I'm doing. Okay. In these kind of spots, I'm just, you know, keeping an eye out for traffic just in general, right? So these kind of things, they send little... red flags towards me. So maybe this has to be improved upon as time goes on. Just something to kind of keep in mind here. Hey there, Yosemite William. I like your name. My name's William, too. It's a nice name. Actually, I like the name Will. Or like William, or Wilfred, or Willard, or Liam, or whoever you know, whatever your name is. Whoever it works, if you guys are also named William out there, it's a good name. I like it. So if you're thinking of a name for your son or daughter, I think maybe more so son. Definitely more so son. I think William's a good name. Okay, so over here, once upon a time, we were putting in some services. I think we might maybe continue with that. So healthcare, we're good. Death care, we probably need a crematorium in this part of the world. And so we could probably use one of the smaller ones. That works. And we probably are okay for schools. We might maybe need a community college somewhere on this end, just to get a little bit of a boost. Actually, one's pretty close by. We could put one over here. Yeah, that's probably fine right there, right? Cool. Oh, I like my name. Well, I mean, there's some people, you know, they just really don't like their name. That's why they change their names, right? But no, I do like my name. I think it's a strong name. And when I was young, I was, you know, I was obsessed with Star Trek. So he's calling myself William Riker, you know? I would sign that and be like, William Riker. People are like, your name's not Riker. I'm like, who are you to judge? Huh? I'm like, I'm your teacher. Put your proper name. I'm like, fine. Fine. You know, like that kind of... I'm like, you raised good points. Okay, so parks, we could probably use a few up here, just to kind of encourage people to move on in. And I'm thinking maybe some sports kind of parks up here, like tennis courts or something. Feel a little bit more inclusive. I know we've got a bazillion of them somewhere. I think they're closer to the end. Oh, right. Oh, oh, golf stuff's here. Good. I was like, did I get rid of all those golf courses? But no, we still have them. Okay, good. We should do a pretty epic golf course for this this city. Hey, Silent Guru, what is going on, my friend? Darn it, did I pass what I was looking for? I know I have these ones. Where did they just go? These ones are a little bit big, though, I think. The tennis stadium? I'm looking for just generic-y kind of... Oh, boy. Because, like, whenever you remove assets or add to your list, it just changes the big order around. So maybe I'm looking in the wrong spots, or maybe they're just in a totally different spot altogether. Maybe I'm just looking, you know? Yeah, maybe I am. Okay, so if I were a tennis court, where would I be? Oh, gosh. Why does this stuff always happen to me? Oh yeah, Eric, he's here too. Yeah, exactly. Well, I have these ones here. Oh, these are huge. Huge. Too big. Well, sir, I guess we're not going to do what I thought. Maybe they're in school stuff? Gosh, I honestly have no idea. Maybe I removed it from the list. So I guess we'll just use one of the bigger ones. Oh well, these things do happen. Track and field, too big. Oh, Guru, we should play some DayZ, you, me, and Eric later tonight. It's been so long since I played DayZ, guys. You'll have to carry me, as always. I'm not really good at that game. Well, I'm not bad, I'm just not really, yeah, I'm not really that good. Okay, will this work? Unfortunately, those people there are complaining about the noise a little bit. I think what we're going to do is extend this slope a little bit. We're actually going to replace that building there with a park. There goes a little bit more of a slope to work with. There we go. So tennis kind of hill right up there, or tennis stadium right on the hill. That's kind of neat, actually. I might move that over just a little bit more. And then give ourselves a little bit more room with the terraforming. And I apologize, guys, for my poor noise being so stuffed. That is the worst. I'm the type two. I don't really like taking, like, I don't really take reactant or, like, you know, tile and all that kind of stuff in general. By the time I take it, you know, it's like it takes like, you know, 2 or 3 hours for it to work on me. I'm not one of those fast acting kind of people. Even if I had like one next to my desk, I would take it now, but it really wouldn't do anything in time. See, it's gonna bear through my nasally voice. Too moist to be carried? That you guys are so strange with the moist thing. Yeah, I know, just with DayZ, I don't know what it is. I just have really bad luck. I'm always dead first. Like, Eric is incredible at, you can just like pop headshots like it's, you know? Like it's his job. Okay, that's kinda cool having this little tennis thing here. I like that. Alright, so that looks really neat too. We should probably put something else in this little semi-section right here. If the ground will kind of work in our favor. Oh, it did, kind of, sort of. But, I think we can terraform this, actually. I'm not afraid to terraform here anymore. I thought I was afraid of terraform. It's just like, no, you know, the option is a little bit more appealing to me. There we go. And the idea is just to get a little bit more zoning in here. Essentially get as much as we can. Which is not very much, but just, you know, any amount kind of helps here. Women's tennis? We could have women's tennis. It could be mixed, maybe mixed use courts. Actually, only one court here. So maybe on some days it's women, some days it's men. Or mixed play, who knows. Okay, now, by that same logic, we should probably put something in back here as well. Just take advantage of this open space back here. And maybe that can kind of come in where the, that avenue is. Yeah, just like that, right? So I'm going to put high density, but just so that it's not too lost in here in terms of height, I'm going to put a park or something right there. These are so big. Oh, we could do one of these little plaza things. Yeah, that's not so bad of an idea. We'll put that in there. Works for me. I love seeing this little train go through. This is really cool. Okay, we could probably use a police station over here, since we're getting some icons for crime. Is that right where the offending area is? Oh, awesome. Look how busy this area is. I love this. This is so cool. It's the little details, right? Like the little train arm goes up, all people go through. Oh god, that person! They ran in front of the train, they're crazy! Is there a reason why I use the slope tool? I don't know. I just kind of click and choose anyone which one. I was using these ones here to get the same height. Just to kind of make things look a little bit more uniform, I guess, but... No, there's no real... I mean, sometimes it's just... There's no method to my madness, you know? So unfortunately, sometimes I might seem a little hypocritical or I do things that kind of counteract what I just did maybe 5 or 10 minutes before, but... I'm caught up in the moments. What can I say sometimes, right? Okay, so we still have that ongoing goal to get our population to 60,000. So let's kind of fill in some more of these areas here. This is going back just a little bit too. And then for here, we'll do a mixture of residential with some commercial. Just because it's probably going to be a little bit loud here with all the traffic going through. Maybe that can go straight through to a little bit like this. Oh, actually like that. There we go. Just mix things up a little bit over here. Okay, so commercial just over here. Oh, last one saying witness this. Some hardcore parkour. Somersaults and flips in front of a train, you know? Take out our high density right there, put in the commercial. I'm gonna see how this goes. This might be a little bit too loud for these residents here, but we shall see. Same with over here, it might just be a little bit loud, because what we have is, you know, we got a highway on and off ramp kind of thing happening. Okay, now the timing of these lights, why is everyone getting so backed up? Same with on this side here, what is the story with this? Do we need wider roads through here? Is that really the option? You know, sometimes adding a wider road doesn't really solve the problem. It's actually a councillor in Toronto, on one of our city councillors. It's not him who said it, so he's quoting someone else, but I'm going to quote him, because that's the only person I can reference at this point. He was saying that adding more lanes to a road is the equivalent to loosening your belts if you're trying to deal with obesity. So that's kind of the metaphor right there. So it's not really the best approach sometimes to necessarily widen the roads, right? I think here we maybe actually did a good thing, but it's when you're doing, you know, traffic kind of fixes in your own city, you know? Just keep that in mind. Oh, and Swimming Duck, we've been up for an hour and 15 minutes, and we maybe had that little hiccup, and I think we were streaming for about 30 minutes prior to that, so I want to say just shy of 2 hours total, hit or miss. Double roundabout, little figure eight kind of thing? I don't know. Double roundabouts, they're kind of hard to do. I'm a sucker for stuff that's already pre-made in the workshop. It's like, look how much cleaner this looks, right? And I'm such a fan, guys. Remember when we did this? It seems like hours, like, it seems like weeks ago we put these in. Change these interchanges over. And this whole thing, too. Okay, I'm gonna put another fire station over here, because we're really not doing too well with fire coverage. And we're gonna have to make some, leisure zones. I need more nighttime money. Guys, you're actually running a negative budget right now. Bring our lights up. And our poor population, I just feel like we've just gone in one big circle this entire stream. Okay, so people are moving in here. All I want to do is just get to 60,000. It just seems like we're never going to get there. Do we need more? We do need some more death care coverage over here. It looks like we should probably do a connection or a bridge or something from here to here as well. Like, this one being the only one might not be the best. I wonder. Oh, you sneaky devil, look at this. Yes. And then we can have this go across. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, delicious. Look at this. This is cool. All them buses? Yep. Actually, we don't really have that many, it's more trams we have in the city. What? How are you out of the lines? I don't believe you. What if that's... Yeah. Yeah, that's what I want. Oh, it's so nice. Backdoor access. Love it. Okay. Now this will go down like that. Okay, so that, I mean, that's fine like that. Why not? We'll just be aware of traffic, because this might be bad what we're doing. We'll see, though. But it just bypasses. That's kind of what we're after, I guess, right? And I was trying to get to here, you know, not really over here, but this still kind of helps a little bit. But I'd like something to go into this spot. Maybe we can share this intersection. So take 12 units to go down, and then maybe go under here, just for funsies. And where are we going with this? What is our goal here? Oh, okay. So something like this, right? Okay, it's a little bit further straight. And then just like that, right? Yeah, I mean, it's not too crazy of a concept. Especially if this is a wider street here, right? And the idea is just to get people, if they want to go over to here, they don't necessarily have to take this as their option. And then I think as time goes on, we'll probably extend this around this way. And we'll maybe do another bridge or tunnel or something with some tram tracks over on that side. This is it. You know, this is good. I think this is critical. Good little junction right here. And you kind of see, we're just keeping an eye on the traffic, because it's not... This area really wasn't designed for too much traffic. So maybe we can widen just that little road there, just to add a little bit of help to the area, just like that, right? Yeah, that works for me. I will get rid of this, though. So we have two sets of traffic lights right there. No, we just have the one. That's a little bit more effective, I think. I almost just... You guys are so... With the moist belly. You guys are so silly. Oh, my goodness. Honestly, what would I do without you guys? You keep me young. oh, I'm so pleased with traffic, and I'm just loving this. Like, this was such a... I was so... not hesitant. I just didn't think we were actually going to do it. When I looked at it, I was like, no, that's so much work. Don't do it. Don't bother. But now we did, I'm happy. It's kind of cool the way this kind of works, too. Just kind of works on the highway. I feel like this should be something, though. There should be a street or, you know? But we don't want to add more traffic here. No, don't do anything. Get out of here. Get away. Moist, moist, moist everywhere. Honestly, I don't know what it is. Like, for those of you who are tuning in, the word moist, for whatever reason, I almost think it's like a naughty word. But you could be talking like a moist towelette. Like, totally nothing. Like, no adult, like nothing, right? Very PG. But the word moist, I don't know. These guys have been teasing me all day. Everything, trying to use moist in every adjective or whatever possible, every sentence possible. Oh, you write this entire tweet. You imagine, yeah. Swimming Duck has like 15 profiles having conversations with himself right here. Oh my goodness. Hey, some people, man, they got a little bit too much free time on their hands. Who am I to judge, right? You guys are welcome to do whatever you want with your own time. I think it's cool you guys happen to spend your time with me. Even if it's only Swimming Duck. Oh, goodness. Okay, so let's do some more zoning in here. Seems like we can probably fit a few things in. Oh, you know, we can probably make this connect to this thing right here. Oh, I know. Yeah, like that. Oh, yeah. And then we'll make this one way. Not the one way. Neat. Yep. Definitely neat. Oh, okay. So some more factories here. And then... maybe we can get a few offices in here. Oh, you'd be so cool is if this goes... I don't know, I'm always on these quests to make things so complicated. Yeah. Oh yeah, look at this. Just to get some extra zones in here, right? Like, who does this kind of stuff? Where's that pillar? There you are. Okay, I want to go straight through... wait, where is it? Okay, let me delete this. I know I could probably achieve most of this with just like a road anarchy mod, but it's kind of fun just, you know, paving your own path and finding a proper way through here, I guess. I don't know, kind of challenging. Okay, there we go. Oh, that fills in that area so nicely. Okay, so that goes like that. Just put some offices in as well, just to mix things up. And then, the plaza or something right here. That's really nice spotted. Cool. And then maybe some trees. Oh, I just realized, and I don't want to jinx it, but I didn't sneeze. Remember, like, 2 minutes ago, I thought I felt like I had to sneeze, and I suddenly thought I was going to? I guess it didn't come in. But my nose, you can see it's all stuffed up. Ugh, that's gross. That's no fun, right? Hate that. Just, like, all the pressure, right? Because, like... outside, there's like a storm kind of rolling in, so you feel the pressure from all of the clouds and everything, you know? Not fun. You ever had a creamy frosting? You know, my favorite kind of frosting is the frosting for the Pillsbury strudels. Those are the best. You used to design your own shapes, too. I would do a little cartoon character of myself whenever I would do my Pillsbury strudel. Because I'm a 4-year-old at heart. Love it. Oh, something I never really showed off during our tour. We still have this really cool harbor area. And for those of you that have joined a little bit late, I have the Prop Anarchy mod working again. So we can go back to making our rail yards the old-fashioned way. Let me show you what I mean by that. So we press Shift and P to turn our Prop Anarchy on and off. And then we find ourselves... what are we looking for here? There's some train stuff, right? Yeah, I got some... tanker cars right here. Remember our issue, we could only get them on one side of this track? Now look at this. Take that. drop this down. Bada bing, bada boom, look at this. Oh god. Symmetry, please. One time. There we go. And we can even use the prop line to draw lines of props. We can probably do that in combination with prop anarchy. We can cackle like evil scientists. Love it. Oh, see, I was having that same problem too with the road anarchy, or sorry, with the prop and tree anarchy. And then I don't know how or why it fixed it, but all I had to do was unsubscribe and subscribe to it again. And I did the same thing with the fine road heights. With the no pillars. A few of them were apparently conflicting, and so most of the main ones, yeah, I just unsubscribed, resubscribed, and that just fixed it. And I have no idea how or why, or if really that was what I ended up doing that made it work, but still very pleased with the end results. Now we can do more train yards. Kind of the short of my long right there. Look at that. It's very nice. Oh, how lovely. This is a cool area too, just in general. Very happy with the way this turned out. And now that it looks like really cool at night. What? Yes. Very cool, right? I love the CN Tower. The city at night is absolutely stunningly gorgeous. Ugh, I love this too. We put our little red, white, and blue spotlighting over here too. Very nice. Lady Liberty. Ooh, gorgeous. Love it. I get so distracted. And what am I going to say? Population. We've got another circle. We're nowhere. I feel like we've done so much, but we're still at 55,000 more or less. Oh gosh. Now, I wonder, is that maybe because we have a lot of... Oh, haha, we do have a lot of old people. So it looks like we're going to be going through a death wave soon. So the way I switch really quickly between day and night is actually a mod called Time Warp. You just right-click anywhere you want on your time map. And for those of you just joining now, I will link the list of mods I have running right now. I have not included the prop anarchy in that list, so it's the only one that's not there. But the one that controls the time, that one is, it's called Time Warp. Another super handy one, which I love, are one-way arrows. That one's in there too, super handy. So feel free to, you know, sneak a peek at that. Don't have to download them all. And if your computer can't really handle too many, in general, mods, they use up your CPU, and then assets use up your RAM, so just kind of plan accordingly. And, oh, I love this. This little thing, this is great. All of this, this train coming in at level... Oh, goodness, what is this? Here I am trying to sing the praise, and what the heck is going on here? Just pause that for a second, see if I can maybe fix that. Nope, I think it's going to be finicky, but... we'll just let that be. Pretend we didn't see that. But yeah, building at night is a little bit tricky. I'm a big fan of it, though. Just kind of looking at the city at night. But it is tricky building at night. I mean, the workaround is just kind of turn up your gamma, I think, a little bit, too. But that makes things look a little bit gray, I think. Oh, and also, too, just a little bit of a tidbit asterisk. So many of you have been sending me custom links and mods and stuff. I had to delete so many of them, so I really apologize, guys. Moist Duck? How long have you been here? What? Have you... Oh, you had to do... Oh, goodness. No, my nose is not moist. My nose is all stuffed up, unfortunately. It's not running. It's just really plugged, which is, like, the worst. It's so funny. Did you hear my whole thing about them teasing me about the word moist and everything? And for the life of me, I don't know what it is. And it's not like it affects me if someone says the word moist. It's not like my day is suddenly like, you know, it's not like I'm not a weirdo or anything like that, right? It's something I think. I think the word moist is just interesting. I don't know, right? Like, oh gosh. Okay. Now you think I'm an absolute weirdo. Let's go back to building. Actually, I think you guys probably knew I was a weirdo ahead of time, but this maybe just seals the deal for some of you. Okay, so I'm not going to connect to this because this was... No. I was gonna say maybe we can treat that almost like a little highway as well, but no, forget I said that. we'll just go across like this, and I'm gonna put some more high density in here. Anyway, what I was saying though, just not too long ago, is our population, most of our people are starting to enter their like end stage in life, so we're gonna be going through a death wave again, unfortunately. So yeah, the population, it's just going in circles right now, which is a little bit unfortunate. So I'm putting commercial here on the outside, just because it's going to be pretty noisy with the, you know, trains kind of going by, right? And I'm just doing this to kind of meet some demand, just get some more, you know, money and that kind of stuff. So this will probably change a little bit, because that's actually quite a little bit of commercial right there, but... Alright, so this now will become some high-density commercial, or sorry, residential. I'm going to put some offices in here. Just for the sake of this maybe being a little bit of a busier kind of, you know, car kind of entrance thing right there. There we go, that's that. Because our goal really is to get to 60,000, so we can kind of unlock some more spaces and have some more area to work with. Oh, look at that, we need more sewage. Okay, so let's, we can probably put more over here. We can put something like that over in our industrial, or we can make a thing over here of utilities. Oh, did we want to put our power plants, like make this like our little 3 mile island and then have like a little offshoot of the rail? I remember we talked about doing that over here, but I don't know now. Moistuck motorway. Oh my goodness, I'm so in favor of that. You guys are hilarious. Moistuck Mountain? Oh, I like that one too. Okay, let's do Moistuck Mountain. Let's do that one. Let's call this area up here Moistuck Mountain. And I really will name some more areas after some of you guys, especially the ones that kind of come here a little more often. Just so you guys can kind of feel like you're a part of the city too. Just some of these names, they kind of write themselves, right? So Moistuck Mountain, that's kind of funny. Let's see if I can spell this correctly. Moist. And am I gonna do it like this, I wonder, for the spelling? Is that okay? Moistuck Mountain, like that? Or should that be two words, do you think? Yeah, the Moistuck. No, I think that's okay, right? That's cool. I like that. My poor coffee. Not that warm anymore. Oh, Cyber Gums, I'm glad you finally made it. Yeah, my streams, I really am hoping to stream more often, guys. And, like, my internet, we were joking about that earlier, it's like, it's I don't know, my internet service provider, they know what I'm up to. They don't want me streaming. They want me just to pay for internet and not to use it, so. Unfortunately, some days my internet is just worse than others, but I do want to stream more often. I would love to become a Twitch partner, so if you guys can help me out with that, just, you know, subscribe, tell your friends to tune in type thing. I applied, and they said I'm just not quite big enough yet, so apply again in a few weeks, so. Gotta keep the momentum train going. But yeah, I definitely want to stream for you guys more often. I love making content for you guys, so it's kind of fun doing all this. And then we'll, no matter what, I'll upload the streams, you know, to the YouTube channel after, just in case you guys can't make it out. And then, okay, so stuffed up, sorry guys. And then, so for those of you that have been following along, as you know, my computer for the last week has been on the fritz. I have not been able to get City Skylines to load, which is why we haven't seen any streams or, any YouTube content, unfortunately, but everything is, you know, it's up and running again, as you can probably see by the stream here. And I removed hundreds, literally hundreds of mods, and maybe six assets, or no, six mods and like hundreds of assets, that's what I wanted to say. And the game, it runs so smoothly now. Even on 3-speed, for a city this size, you can see there's a difference. See, 1-speed, 3-speed, look how fast everything moves. That's really nice. Okay, so sun back up. So what I was trying to say with that is I'm going to be recording like a madman this coming, you know, week or two. So expect episodes for like all cities that we've been working on, essentially. Oh, my fix? I mean, really what it was is just I eventually deleted the game and I moved all the save game files. So I kind of erased the entire imprint of City Skylines from my computer. And then what I did is I reinstalled it. And I did the that little launch command to disable mods and not allow the workshop. And then I was able to launch the game. So worst case scenario, we could always, you know, retrieve the save files, because I put those back in the right spot type thing. And then I just kind of went through the list. I just was like, how many mods can we run until the game breaks? And I just it took me 4 or 5 days of just that. And I just scaled down. I had almost 1,500 mods / assets. And we had to bring that list down to, I don't know where it's at now, maybe 11 or 1,200 or so, but many, many, many hours. And then what I would do is I would, you know, I eventually could get the game to load, because originally I couldn't even make it past the Paradox loading screen. And then I could finally get the game to run, and then it was just a matter of I would try to load a map, it would take 10 or 15 minutes and it would cycle, and then it just would crash. And I'd be like, oh, come on, really? And so I'd remove like 4 or 5 more assets, restart my game, try the whole thing again, and that would be like a 20-minute kind of, you know, cycle right there just to find out it didn't work. Hey there, to freaking Batman, that's a cool name. Thanks for stopping by. Happy Sunday. Hope you're well. And hello to the rest of you guys. Got a lot of lurkers today. I like that. Seeing some big numbers here. So yeah, I was just saying, if you guys want, I mean, subscribe. I'm trying to, you know, do some more streaming more often. And it's always nice to have an audience, so I definitely want to, you know, start taking this a little more seriously. Hopefully add another day to the roster. We can start streaming maybe, you know, 2-3 times a week instead of only once or twice. Yeah, I don't know what it was. I think it was one of the assets or mods that got downloaded. Like, if you modify them and they end up taking a little bit too much of your system resources, it kind of throws things out of whack. And I also read that there's a few mods that have memory leaks. So as your cities get a little bit too big, you kind of run into problems, that kind of stuff. You guys don't like the... you don't like? Oh yeah, well, Moist Duck is very interesting. I like Swimming Duck too. We're a very duck kind of themed city, it seems like. But yeah, no, I mean, I'm happy to be back. So we'll see, we'll see some more content. And I definitely want to keep streaming City Skylines just in general. I do want to start adding some more games to the roster. Like, I want to start streaming Train Fever. I want to stream Scrap Mechanic. I want to maybe stream some DayZ. But, I mean, that's a little bit more of a mature game. So it might be some bad words, you know, that kind of stuff. So if you guys are interested, I'll do it. Because I used to stream DayZ in the past, and had a few of you guys tune in for that, so... Maybe some of you guys are even here from that, you know? So, like, old school days. Follower who's been here before? Oh, well, I'm not saying you're the first time here, the freaking Batman. I just mean, like, it's a cool username nonetheless, right? And also, some of you, I can't remember all of your names, right? Actually, it's funny. Some of you on YouTube especially, I won't remember your names, but I'll remember what your thumbnail looks like on your little YouTube thing. And so sometimes I just, you know, I'll see a comment based on that, and I'll recognize you just on that alone, which is kind of fun. Some of you guys, you know, you comment on every single video I make, which is really cool. Alright, let's just do some more zoning, slowly get our population up. I'm actually going to move this, because it's not really looking too good with the slope kind of issues right there. We definitely need some fire coverage, though, over here, so we can't go too far away with this. Well, maybe over here, actually. I mean, somewhere that's a little bit more flat, basically. Yeah, that's a better spot. Okay, so let's fill that area back in right there. Hey, Pete McTavish, what's going on? I haven't seen you in a while. Thanks for stopping by tonight. Yeah, I know you guys are a little bit older, but I know some of you watch this with your kids and that kind of stuff. That's what I mean. And then some of you don't mind having your kids just kind of watch this, you know, because I really don't swear. Like, it's not really my thing. I will swear in games like DayZ, just because, you know, the game itself is swearing. Sometimes people are swearing at you, heat of the moment, that kind of stuff. But for, like, City Skylines, you know, I try to keep it friendly, so. So in that sense, that's kind of what I was referring to. Because I wouldn't necessarily, like, you know... If you're babysitting, don't put this on if I'm playing DayZ, that kind of thing, right? But I think I would do a little bit of a disclaimer. And then in general, I don't really like to, you know, I'm not really one for swearing. I think it has its time and place, but, you know, when you're streaming, not really, right? Like, you don't really, I don't know, it doesn't make you sound really that cool, right? Because people are all like, F this, F that, or like, you know, I don't know. It just makes you seem a little bit childish. Okay, now all I'm really doing right here is just trying to extend some of these little side roads here to get some more zoning in. But you can kind of see it's a little bit challenging with the terrain being what it is. Moist Duck, what do we got here for us? The oh my goodness. all 15 of your Williams love the stream? You have 15 kids named William, is that... I think I would name my... Actually, you know, it's funny, my, so my dad, his name is Ken, and my grandpa's name is Ken, like Kenneth. And my dad was like, please, can we name him Kenneth? My mom is like, no, absolutely not. So they almost call me Andrew, which I would not have minded. Like, my middle name is Andrew. But yeah, I stuck with William. I think I like that the most, to be honest with you. Okay, let's try naming this. Oh, winner, winner, yes. That's what I'm after. And I think if we play our cards right in this little spot here, we might be able to get a little bit more zoning just in this spot here. And I think that's going to require some terraforming. Yeah, FDF bomb, exactly. You don't need it. You know, time and place, right? Like, I swear with my friends that kind of stuff, right? But I think you guys know what I mean, just fundamentally, you know? Time and place for it all. Oh no, it didn't even open up any more zoning squares. Darn it, that was the whole point of that. Maybe we can get, come on, maybe one or two, come on. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. There we go, we can get a whole house in there now. My new mixtape? Yeah, mixtape coming out, that's right. Actually, I used to make killer mixtapes back in the day. You know, we used to record, like, your, you know, from the radio, from CD. Oh my goodness, so long ago. Actually, what I was like a little budding entrepreneur. So in like in grade 7 or grade 8 when I was in like middle school. And, oh gosh, how long ago was that? I don't even know what year that would have been. That would have been like, probably like 1998, 1999 kind of thing, right? So like, you know, like Napster and like LimeWire, all that was like new. And like no one really knew how to like burn CDs or anything, right? But I knew how because I was a bit of a tech kid. So I remember I would go to Costco or like Sam's Club, I think at the time, right? And I would buy in bulk like a pack of like 50 CDs. And I would tell my friends, listen, man, I'll burn you a disc. Just, you know, write down 10 or 20 tracks you like. You know, send me some money. I would charge, like, you know, like, 10 bucks usually or whatever. And I would just make CDs all week for people. And I would just, yeah, I would make, like, you know, 4, 5, 6 CDs. And I was a young hustler. I had a little envelope with my cash and that kind of stuff. And, like, oh my goodness. So, it just, I don't know, it's just kind of funny, right? So I'd always be, like, the cool kid. I'd have, like, pockets full of money, and I'd be like, you guys want something from the vending machine? And they're like, yeah, Will, you give me a cherry Coke? I'm like, no problem, guys, no problem. Too funny. Yeah, you're young, 1998. Yeah, I was born in 1986, which seems like, I guess, a long time ago, but not really at the same time. But I'm turning 30 years old in July, which is pretty soon. So I can't believe that. Was leading to copyright infringement? I hope not. Okay. I think we maybe need some more services or some parks or something over here. This area, it's filling in, but not really as quickly as I thought it would. Oh, looks like maybe schools are the options, or the answer. Yes, I think we need another school over here, so let's maybe make that go further like that. There we go. That should help a bit. And how are we doing for healthcare coverage? Not too bad. Probably use something over here, though. Yeah, maybe just use a little clinic right next to our tennis facility. That kind of works for me. You don't trust anyone born after the year 2000? Well, there's a lot of them now. Holy smokes. And you know what's really scary? They're just getting their licenses, and they're just starting to drive! They're filling the roads! Run away! Panic! Teenagers! Oh my goodness. I remember when I was driving, learning how to drive. Holy smokes. Seems like it was ages ago. About to turn 19? You're almost, no longer a teenager. You'll be soon in the 20s. Then you'll start making all those jokes about how old you're getting, you know? 19, it really was a good year. Because in Canada, you can drink at the age of 19. And we actually have one province, it's one province next to mine, so one province over, it's about a 6-hour drive or so, and you can drink there at the age of 18. So kind of a cool thing to do when you're 18 years old, if you live in Ontario, is you take like a weekend trip to Quebec, you know, go over there. And what's really cool about Quebec, just some random Canada facts here. So Ontario, the province I live in, and provinces are just like states, province I live in, we can only buy our alcohol through government retailers, which seems so, like, archaic and, like, strange and, like, Soviet. But we have like government-run alcohol stores. So we can't go to a gas station, we can't go to a corner store, we just can't go to a private store and buy beer or booze or anything. It's really weird. There's very few. You can have like breweries and stuff. There's some exceptions, obviously, or in some random wine shops. But for the most part, you have to go to this place called the LCBO, which is the Liquor Control Board of Ontario. It's a store, and they have like regular hours. But yeah, I mean, so it's like if they're closed, if it's like 11:45 p.m. on a Friday night and you want booze, you gotta go to a bar, which is like so silly. You can't just buy alcohol. So I don't know, that seems kind of strange. But in Quebec, you can go like, you know, 2 a.m. to a grocery store if they're still open and you can buy it. So they're very different rules. And then the province of Alberta, they have like the coolest rules. That's the province where all those, you know, kind of forest fires are happening right now in the western provinces. So in Alberta, you're allowed to buy your alcohol at, you know, corner stores, gas stations, that kind of stuff. But let's say those are closed for the day, and all that's open is a bar. Well, you're allowed to buy beer to go, as long as it's sealed from a bar. You can even buy booze, you can buy like a bottle of tequila, that kind of stuff. It has to be sealed, and you're paying a little bit more for it type thing, right? But just kind of, it's funny that that's an option. Okay, so our population's slowly moving, guys, now that we've been kind of sitting here chatting for a little bit. Oh, you're 28? Yeah, close to my age, I'm 29. You're 26? Oh, Dan, you're 15, eh? You're a young one. Yeah, that happens to be a French province over in Quebec. They do speak a lot of English, because our country is bilingual. 46, he might be the winner. I have a few people that message me, that watch me, they're in their 60s and 70s, but I think it's kind of cool. They're still tech savvy and stuff, right? But you know what, as far as I'm concerned, guys, age, it's only a number. You're as young as you feel. And also, too, it's like, you know, it's life experiences. Those also age you. Because you can be, you know, 25 years old, and maybe you've never even left your home city. So, like, really, what have you done? You know, arguably, right? Or you could be a 20-year-old, and maybe you've traveled 5 or 6 countries already. You know, you've lived, you know, you've been in love, all this stuff, right? You've just had more life experience. So that kind of stuff, that ages you. I think that kind of shows when you meet someone. You can kind of just see how far along the experience line they are, almost, if that makes any sense. Now, I think what I'm making here might be a little bit too steep, so I'm actually going to back that up a little bit. I think the best approach for this kind of steepness is to maybe keep them kind of like that. Yeah, it's better for the zoning. We're just a little bit stuck, though, with our options, because we're unfortunately cut off right here because of the you know, city boundary. You have an 18 and 50-year-old kid. Holy smokes. Like, honestly, I think it'd be crazy to be a dad. Like, you know, one day down the road, who knows? I just feel like I have some cool stuff to pass on. It's not really, I don't know, maybe not ready yet. But I'm a cool Uncle Will, because, like, a lot of my friends have kids, right? So they're always like, when can Uncle Will come over? I'm only there for the good stuff, which I like. So, I mean, you know, it just takes a whole community to raise a kid, too. So it's kind of fun just going over and doing that with my friends sometimes. Oh, and those of you who do live in Europe, yeah, I'm so jealous. It's so easy to travel. You guys can just hop on a train and just be, you know, just fall asleep even. When you wake up, you're like 5 countries over. Yeah, I mean, there's some people, they just really, I mean, they want kids so badly, but then the second they get them, they're like, oh gosh, I regret this. And there's others, they don't want kids, and the second they come, that's it, they're totally changed, and, you know, their life is for their kids now. So kids, I mean, it's such a perspective and awakening. It's one of those things, be careful what you wish for, you know? There we go. This looks a little bit better, right? Okay, we still didn't put in that sewage, goodness gracious me, I totally forgot about that. Okay, so we have these things here we can use, super, super simple. We have a little bit of a zone set up already. See right over here. We can add to that. Or what I was going to say is we can build our own little thing on this island here. And this is where we could put one of the power plants. Like one of our nuclear power plants when we start using that eventually. So that, I mean, I don't know. Is that straight? Straight-ish? I'm trying to just do it kind of lined up with that. I don't think that's too bad of a job, right? Maybe we can expand on this. Oh, definitely it's all, yeah, you need for sure a responsible partner. Like, kudos and, like, absolute mad props to single parents, but if possible, like teamwork, you know? That's the ideal situation right there. It's also, if you have a cool partner, it's cool. You know, it's like your partner in crime, essentially, too. That's kind of the whole fun of it, right? Yeah, it's one of those things, you know, you just, the second you stop looking, that's when you'll find him. If you're out searching, it ain't gonna happen. Or it might happen, might just feel like it's a slow pace or something, who knows, right? Yeah, I like this, we're getting kind of deep here this stream, guys. Okay, that's not the worst transition. That could be a little bit smoother, but I think we'll still allow that. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to terraform this a little bit, because it's here. Nice. You need a moist partner for kids? Oh my goodness, this is starting to, See, this is why, you kind of see why I think moist is an adult word, right? You can kind of see it just quickly steers the conversation, right? Oh my goodness, you guys. You guys are so funny. Back to talking about cakes. I like cake. People call me boring, but you know what? I like vanilla cake. Vanilla icing too, even. To each their own, though, obviously. Okay. Alright, so water. Here we go, finally. Some water treatments. And I'm going to leave some space in between. Between them, so we can still put some roads and maybe put in some like, oh, we can probably put in some like lighting or something cool over here too. Okay, so maybe we can double them up and then put a service road in between. That looks kind of cool. And then something else that we could do is we could put in some like clarifers, like some of these things here. So I actually think these things double as, I think they work in this game too. I think they're functional. And, you know, honestly, we can make them almost work as kind of like mini, like fake kind of cooling ponds in case we put our power plant over here, which I think we will do. Like, why not, right? So it'd be like a nuclear power plant. Oh, that fits almost rather well in there. There we go, just put that like that. And then what I'm trying to do is just get a one gap space around it so that we can put a pedestrian pathway like this. Kind of fills that in rather nicely. That's kind of cool. And then, you know what, we might maybe need a little bit of terraforming just to kind of make this work a little bit more effectively. Yeah, that's fine with me. That's cool. And then over right here. Oh, that does work. Cool. I was worried we weren't going to have enough room for that, but we do. Okay, so let's close that off. Let's connect these all up. Just connect that like that. Perfect. We should see this now go right up. Neato presto. Now, what we should do actually over here is maybe make like a security checkpoint or something. And goodness, I feel like I have to sneeze. Oh no, it's coming. Wait, am I gonna do... Oh, maybe. Oh, I want to, but I'm stopping myself. Oh darn it, I think I just ruined it. I kind of like sneezing. It's like, it's good relief. I want to, I can feel it. No! Stop trying to stop yourself from sneezing. Okay, so what I'm looking for right here, I'm gonna focus on it, is I have a few of these downloaded. Here they are. Kind of like a toll booth kind of checkpoints here. Oh, we can put that along the side. Ooh, interesting. Yeah, we can probably make that work in our favor, I think. Okay, so let's see here. What would we need to make that work? I think we need a wider road. Okay, so let's try this thing here. Perfect. And we'll probably go like this even, just make that wide the whole way in like that. What is this duck? Oh my gosh! How dare you. Lionsbane, you silly man. Love it. Okay, sorry for the stuffy nose here, guys. Okay, so let's restart our day, get some more lights. Put this. Now, does this work well with the lanes, or do we have to be creative? Oh, it does! Well, that's handy. Oh, it even spawns police cars, too. Cool. We kind of see, essentially right here, what we're doing is creating like a security checkpoint so no random people can kind of drive in here. And so what we probably would have to have is a way out. So if you're not security clearance or you're just doing a delivery and you have to go back, you need a way out type thing. So let's do that. And I think we'll do that. Maybe on a little bit of a bridge kind of thing. So just bring that up. Just like that. There we go. And then that can just reconnect like this. And then, oh, actually I wanted this to be one lane. Or one way, sorry. There we go. Oh, and you know what? I've made that, unfortunately, one unit too close because we're getting that, Oh, I would love it. I was just saying a little bit earlier, the allergy pills, though, even though if I take one right now, it don't work fast enough. Usually by the time I go take one, it's like my allergies are already starting to improve, but they're unfortunately getting a little bit worse because there is a storm that's coming right now. So it's probably going to rain a little bit later on. That's kind of cool, right? A little bit of this checkpoint kind of action right here, so only authorized personnel are allowed in. And then what we can do is maybe clean some of these trees out. We can put in a like a fence or something like that, right? What we can have is maybe like a little facility style area ahead of the checkpoints. Just have a few buildings, say right here. And then we can just kind of continue this along with like a fence or something, right? Okay, so let's see if we can make that happen. Oh wait, we can use our prop line. Okay, tell me your secrets. Oh wait, why isn't this working? Oh no, did I mess this up? Oh wait, there it goes. I'm just slow to... Cool. So these are all the props we have downloaded. Gosh, oh gosh, oh gosh. Where on earth am I gonna find a fence? Gosh, copy is terrible. Oh my goodness. It's like, it's almost at the good kind of cold, but it's like just like past the point where it's warm now, so it's like kind of cold and like just like a little kind of tasting. But it's coffee, so I love it. There we go, so industrial fencing is what I'm after. Oh cool, we have spacing options now. I don't think we had that before. I like when mods get updated. Let's move these out of the way. Oh, you can change the size of it? What? Oh, what? That is so cool. Okay. Look at that! There's a little fence. That's a wild, yeah. Okay, so how do we make this happen here? We want big fencing. Now, why isn't that a taller fence, I wonder? Yeah, that's not really kind of a tall fence. That's not what I want. Delete that, draw a line again. Let's try this again. Maybe it's a different fence we can use here. Well, maybe not actually. Oh gosh, no. What? Ooh, nope. Okay, well, maybe this is not the most effective way to do what I wanted to do. Perhaps we can try this as our option. Oh, right, industrial. There we are. Fences. See, that fence, this is what I want. I wanted a line of these. This is not what we got, though. Okay, so that's essentially what I'm after. and this will be a little bit painstaking, and oh my goodness, this is going to be really exhausting. Okay, so our slope is not... there we go. Okay, I'll do my best to make this kind of quick, and we'll just see if we can motor this across. I think I'll get the hang of it probably by the time we're on our last segment. It's a shame this wasn't working with that prop line kind of tool, but... I mean, it doesn't have to be a perfect line, but all I'm trying to do is just create this, like, fake kind of barrier feeling. Just so that, you know, people who don't belong in the power plant area would not kind of sneak around, you know? There's a rain cloud heading my way right now. Yeah, I heard, like, there's a some storm warnings just for outside of the city. Traditionally, and of course, knock on wood, by the time the storm hits Toronto, usually it's all rained out. Usually it's just a little bit west and north. That's kind of where the big storms kind of roll through, just the way the lakes are kind of set up. So by the time it gets here, it's not really too bad. Of course, I say this and watch, like, you know, we have this, like, killer storm tonight that knocks out power, right? But you never know. Okay, so I'm going to make this go just right to the edge of this little kind of wood area, essentially. Not wood area, where the kind of slope thing here is. But we could make this into a wooded area by adding trees and stuff. Or we could even just kind of finish this fencing off like this. Yeah, I'm fine with this as an option. That's not so bad, right? And I have something really cool too that we can use over here too, just to kind of make the area feel a little more real. Okay, so I'm not going to go the whole length of this area here, but just, you know, just enough of it to kind of make it feel real. Okay. There, just like that, so, you know, that's enough, right? It doesn't even go straight, so that's fine. I don't think you should be googling moist. You see what I mean? Like, I have this, like that's not a bad word. What is the wrong with the word moist? I'm so weird. Oh my boy. You guys are funny. You guys bring out the sillies in me. Alright, so, as far as making this area kind of fun and unique, let's maybe do something like this. Okay, so we can change this part of our fencing. Maybe we can just sneak a little bit more of this in. Couple segments. Yeah, just like that, right? That's a bit better. Okay, now, just a little bit of commercial, some offices. These would be basically like some of the control buildings for our power plants. But we're not going to zone the whole thing up for obvious reasons. I don't want to be too busy over here. And I want some truck style things and some assets and then power plants. What's the word I'm looking for? Fire station. What is this we got right here? Keep calm and stay moist? Alright. Oh my goodness, that's a good one actually. I like that one. You guys are funny. There, that's filling in nicely. Just kind of stretch that like this. Oh, and let me show you that cool thing I have, too, that we can use. I think they're in this part. I think. Yeah, okay, where are you? Harbor. Airport, nuclear power plant, there you are. Control P for our prop anarchy. We can put that, say, right over here if we want to. That's kind of fun, right? So as you're driving towards, you see that sign? And we can even have that on this side as well. So you let kind of people know when they're approaching that this is the way to the power plant. That's kind of fun, right? Add some realism to this. Oh, that poor cat. Oh, that's so sad. Someone did not want to get a bath. What kind of duck is that? I don't think that's a duck. This is kind of cool. I'm digging this. Okay, so let's put up a little police station. Not that that really doesn't work as a police station, I just want a little bit more over here, just in terms of, like, police slash, you know, like, that kind of presence feeling. There we go, I like that. And then some more buildings right here. And then maybe along here should be some, like, storage or, like, cooling tower style, you know, like, areas or whatever. The road after. Let's put in... Where are they? Yes, these things here. We can use some of these. Some fuel. That's kind of cool, right? That's a little bit of realism, I think. And then we'd probably need some, if I removed assets and still have this many, trust me. So I had, if you can imagine, I had almost 1,500 before, and I took like 200-400 out or so. I really don't know the exact number, because I stopped looking, because it was driving me mental. But it took me like a week of just troubleshooting. Was this the tennis courts I was looking for the whole time? No, those were the big ones. I guess those were not them. I remember before I was looking for tennis courts, though. Okay, I'm gonna build like a little truck stop thing over here. And I want just some more generic kind of facility oil kind of feeling things over here. That works. And too bad we can't zone anything right there, right? Or even move that. Oh, we can move that over. Okay, that's fine. Okay, so just a little bit more. Oh, the prop energy's on. That's why those trees are being a little crazy right there. The trees. You guys are so funny. The rain makes it look moist. It does. You guys are making me uncomfortable. I'd get an adult here. Oh boy. Alright, what am I looking for? You guys are distracting me here. Stop distracting me. Transportation. Oh, we don't even have this unlocked yet. Darn it, I can't use some of those assets. What am I looking for here? Oh, this is stuff I'm looking for. That's right. So I want, like, parking lots, like, that kind of stuff, right? I don't think we can use any of these, this parking lot or so. This might be a little bit too big. Oh, no, that's fine. Maybe that can go over here, though. Kind of mix things up a little bit. Actually find some more parking lot things. No, that's not quite it. Those are too big. That's fine like that. If we terraform it, though. Just bring that up. Perfect. I wouldn't say perfect, but it's better. Okay. Now, I just want some, like, you know, factory-style... power lines! Oh, thank you, yes! Very good for the reminder. Sorry, guys. Totally lost in my own little world. This is why I got you guys helping me out. Those will go like that, from there to there. And that will go like that, from there to there. Okay, so that is that. And then to make it look like a little bit more real, I guess, not the word I want to use, we'll put like a little relay box or just something over here. Oh, that'd be closer to the road. Oh no! I just deleted our... little power line. Okay, that's close enough. Perfect. Bring this back. Oh no! You see that? That's not what I want. There we go. And then over here, we'll just put a utility box. I actually don't think this is. Oh, it is connected. Okay, never mind. Power lines and moisture don't mix, you're absolutely right, they don't. Safety first now, guys. Okay, so in this little spot here, I just want kind of some industrial feeling assets. So maybe we can put even some like shipping containers or just something. Don't necessarily have to, but let's see what we got for options here. So we got like these kind of buildings we can use. Just like generic truck stops, like that kind of stuff, right? Just some industrial kind of feeling buildings. And then this terraform, just so things look a little more even around here. And I have an idea to actually sneak a road through the back part of this so we can still get some access. So let's try that. I remember though, because of the way the boats come in, we can't really go too much further out. Is there a power limit to how much? I don't think so. That's a really good question. I don't really think you have to worry about stepping up or down the voltage. That would be incredibly complex if they added that kind of depth to this game, though. And, like, kudos to them if they ever did something like that, but I doubt we would see that kind of complexity or depth to the game. I think people would complain too much. They'd be like, it's too real, please, I can't do it. Okay, let's give that. Look at that, perfect. Make that a little bit wider, just so it looks cool. And then in here, we gotta be cautious not to put any anything that pollutes, because we got our water, right? So let's go like this with some offices. Your city's ultra unrealistic? Oh, no. I'm sure it's not that bad. I just like to add little extras, you know, here and there. How big are these? Oh, these aren't so bad. A couple of those. And this, I think, would be too big to use over here. And I don't really think it would have a real-life purpose, to be honest with you. So maybe we won't use that. It would be kind of cool to get a boat over here, though. If we had, like, another like harbor that we weren't using that we connected. I think we have enough fake assets and stuff. We could probably make that happen, to be honest with you. In fact, I'm sure we could. So maybe we won't do that now, but like something we can kind of, you know, keep an eye on for keep an eye out for later on. Okay, so I think I'm actually gonna change this slightly. I think I'm gonna go say like this. Connect that like that. And then this will go in here. Oh, actually. That will go like this. And we could probably fit a couple more of these just right there. And where were those? I think right here, right? Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Now, pedestrian pathway would fit in between here, I wonder. Oh yeah, yeah. And then here, this should be, you know, concrete. Like, I don't have any of those concrete things left, so we're gonna have to improvise by using, unfortunately, some pathways, right? But yeah, I don't think I can get better than that. But we can put some trees in there, though. That's what we can do. Let's fill that in a bit. There, that's kind of neat. Kind of unique as well. A little bit of charm to the area as well. You guys are so funny with your little moist comments still. Too moist for you? I think I'm agreeing with you. Okay, so here, maybe just a little bit of offices. And just like a hint of commercial. Don't want to block our sign. Put an ambulance station over here. Just so we can get some, you know, health coverage over here. Just a little bit of that. This is not too bad. Not too bad at all. Quite like this. And as a bonus, we should have like crazy amounts of power now. Blah, 2200. What? That's a wicked. Nice. We got enough room to like triple our city size before we gotta put another power plant in. That's really awesome. Have I thought about getting Rogue Anarchy? Oh, I just, wait, I should have it on. Oh yeah, wait, where is it? Yeah, see, it's on. There it is. I was like, did it disappear? It's just hidden. I actually never use it, to be honest with you. I only have it on, because I also have the sharp angles junction or whatever. I only have it so we can make like tighter intersections. Otherwise, I don't really actually use that for its like intended purpose, which is really interesting. I don't know why I don't, but just a little random little tidbit right there. I did terraform. Oh no, actually no, the islands, I didn't terraform it in. This was actually here already. Just kind of added a little bit to it. And this one, actually, I can track down the track down the link for this map for you guys. Oh gosh, where is it? If I was a map link, I would be... Aha! Here you are, my friend. So if you guys want to play along, there's a map right there. And if you guys want a list of the mods I'm using, here is that as well. Yeah, the anarchy lets you... Oh, it does, eh? It lets you put the concrete tiles... Well, the prop anarchy lets you kind of do that as well, I'd say. So, I mean, I feel like, you know, some of my anarchy mods might maybe do kind of the same thing. So maybe they kind of overlap a little bit, but... I know, just in general, I don't necessarily get the most out of some of my mods, but that's just because I'm a little finicky and kind of, you know... I guess I'm stubborn sometimes, it... Oh, well. To each their own. Okay, so I think this is a pretty successful little side kind of island here. It's kind of was what we were after. And we could do something similar where we make like a little prison island, because we're gonna have to put a prison in eventually as well. Otherwise, I like our little industrial area. It has a nice feel to it. And traffic does not seem to be an issue here at all, which is like just wonderful. And even in general, we have a lot of cars coming into this area, but it's not too bad. So this is just kind of high volume because we got a traffic light at this intersection. And this, I mean, hypothetically, what we could do is make a bridge so that the highway doesn't have to stop here, in air quotes, and it can just kind of continue along down. But I think we are more than okay with what we have so far. And this, we'll just keep an eye on it. And by that, I mean in terms of traffic. Because this area here is starting to get a little bit busy. And it was, yeah, the island to the left of the docks. Do you think that one would be good? Oh, this one a little down here, you mean? Yeah, that could totally, totally be a little Alcatraz kind of prison island for us. Oh, which one are you talking about here? Batman, that one, or... Oh, the surface painter. Yeah, you know what? I just saw that one got added. I haven't downloaded it yet because I had to remove so many to get this working. But I that one I have on my list to try and test out to see if it's good. I'm fairly certain it'll make it into my little roster. Oh, what's this mod here? Yeah, same one. Yep. Okay, well guys, just keeping an eye on the time. I think we might maybe be wrapping it up in about 10 minutes or so. I actually streamed a little bit longer than I had planned on, but that's totally not a problem. I love getting caught up with you guys, especially, you know, lost in conversation type thing. But we'll be doing another stream later this week. I'm not 100% on the day just yet, but definitely subscribe. So we'll be doing streams more often. And what I'm hoping to do in the long run is kind of pick up the amount of streams we're doing. So instead of doing, say, only one or two a week, maybe we can do two or three. So I really want to start, you know, trying to make Twitch a little bit more of a priority. Hopefully we can get, you know, up to Twitch partner status even. Oh, what's this over here? You guys are so funny. You guys keep linking funny little memes and pictures of, you know, anything that has the word moist in it. You guys are jokers. I love you guys. You guys are funny. How long have I been streaming for? 2 hours, 20 minutes for this one. We had a little bit of a connection problem, so I think we have maybe an additional 30 minutes added on to that. But it was my intention just to stream for only a couple hours today, but it's been a while. So yeah, I always seem to get a little bit carried away, which is totally fine. In general, I don't really try to stream for a little bit for too long, just because I do post this to my YouTube channel afterwards. And, you know, some people, they don't really have enough time to kind of keep caught up, which is totally fair, so just kind of giving you guys a heads up on that. Alright, well, I mean, I don't know. I like our city. I'm just kind of mad that we didn't hit 60,000. We might actually do it by the end of the stream, but I just feel like we should have hit that a long time ago, right? Okay, well, what is our population age? Still pretty old, right? Well, let's just do it. We're so close. Let's just get this up. Oh, yes, as a matter of fact, yes, I recorded that just before I streamed, and the reason why I didn't have part 2 out earlier is for the last week I've been battling with computer issues, so I wasn't able to get the game to go past the Paradox loading screen, so I had too many assets and mods, so it's just like the biggest just headache this week trying to like shave down my list to a point where we can get the game playable again. But you guys can, you know, you can see, right? Like, the city, it's a fairly decent size now, and we're on 3 speed, and things are still moving pretty smoothly. Like, 1 speed, no complaints. My computer is, like, you know, pretty happy with that, right? Mr. Lionsbane, I will see you later, my friend. Message me on Twitter. I don't know if I'll have Steam online or not tonight, if you want to game a bit. I will see you later, man. Okay. So, population, where can we just drop in a few more houses? Oh, goodness gracious me, we've got a lot of problems over here. Anyway, so I don't have a date in mind, but I am hoping to stream, you know, maybe like Tuesday night, Wednesday night, Thursday night, who knows. For sure we'll kind of keep with our streaming Sundays. Kind of enjoying doing that. So hopefully you guys can tune in next Sunday night, or next Sunday afternoon, I should say. It depends on where you live, actually. Okay, so why don't we do one more little just off-road kind of coming in like this. And then hopefully get that to work. There we go. But yeah, I'll be doing some more tutorial videos. I plan on recording, you know, basically like every day this week. And when I'm not recording, we'll probably sneak in a couple streams. But I gotta get caught up. I'm a little bit behind. I'm basically 6 days behind uploading. So I gotta do some videos for all the cities we're working on, as well as some of the tutorial stuff. I want to introduce some more tutorials, so lots to do. Yes! Woohoo! We did it, guys! Only took us 3 hours, too. Holy smokes. Finally, what? Look at this, 60,000. Awesome. Very cool. Look at that, population's already below 60,000 again. Ah, too funny. Love it. Well, that was good. I didn't think we were actually going to do that before the stream. And when I opened my mouth and started saying that before, I didn't realize we were that close to 60,000, so... Ooh, that was good. Kind of cheese tacos. 60,000 hype? Yeah, baby. Okay, so... What did we actually unlock there? I think we got the rest of our, Oh, no, we didn't. Yeah, we just get this. This is what I want. 70,000. A new spot, though, that does help us. What should we buy? I think realistically this is probably the best one to buy, right? A whole new spot of room right here to open up some ground and build some new neighborhoods. That'd be kind of nice. And then I think we can get to 70,000, like, super quick time. I'll definitely get that done next stream. What else we got here, though? Oh, we got the airport! Oh, well, how lovely! That's really nice. So... airport. We could do that next stream as well, actually. Yeah, that'd be an awesome thing to do. So, I think we'll have to get to 70,000 just so we can unlock a little bit more space, but I remember saying last stream that maybe we could do an airport in this spot right there. No, what picture are we talking about? Oh, this most recent one here. The word moist are used to describe cake or towel lads. Oh! Oh yeah, I'm keeping that open. I'm gonna send that to someone else because people know that I'm a weirdo when it comes to the word moist. Oh, I love it. Oh, you're having fajitas for dinner. Oh yes, please put up a chair for me as well. That's too funny. I appreciate you guys linking all this fun stuff for me. You guys are funny. Well, guys, you know what we did. So let's do a little run through on all the things we accomplished this stream, because it was a lot. When we first started, which seems like forever ago, we just started moving some of our utilities, garbage collection, that kind of stuff, up to this little area here in the hills. So we got our incinerator, a little bit of power generation. It's kind of fun. Quite like this. And what's really neat is we do have the option to maybe do an observatory on one of the other hills, say like over here or something, right? Just the same kind of idea. And we got this nice little suburb kind of thing in the hills kind of surrounding it, which is pretty nice. Kind of a mix of some tunnels. And I think I might do this on my own time, but what I'm going to go through is hopefully add some more of these kind of rocks to create some more kind of cliffs, especially in and around this spot here. Kind of add things out. I don't know, it just seems like we did so much and so little at the same time, right? Because in the grand scheme, like, what did we even do? We did so many, actually I did this off camera, so it doesn't really count, but we reworked so many of our interchanges. So this right here, entirely different. Love it though, because as you can see, it is working wonders for high volumes of traffic here. That's all kinds of cool. Like, all kinds of cool. I love this. Got a train working through here too, and it's just really neat. It's like I'm just digging the, you know, the factories. I'm loving all these rails going through. Got our cargo trains, this high speed. Ah, guys, this is great. I would totally live here. I'm about to say next time I'm the mayor. I would totally live here. This is a great, great city. And so we found a really cool way to kind of rebuild the highway. Remember this before was just that single road. It was these kind of roads here. We're using these, and then we were going in with our traffic president to kind of change the speed limits around, and it was just like a whole bunch of crazy work, right? But now we've upgraded the whole thing into an actual full-fledged highway now. So that's pretty cool. So that goes through here. We have this new interchange here, which replaced what we had before, that weird little double roundabout kind of thing. Yeah, I know you can, I don't know what mod it is that allows you to, but there's, you can kind of see down in the tunnels now. They got some texturing right inside, which is kind of neat. It might be the No Pillars mod, I'm not really 100%, or maybe it's the Network Extensions, I don't know. Or Network Skins, who knows, one of those cool mods. Anyway, this is kind of fun, right? So the highway breaks off, goes under the bridge here, the way on is kind of right here. It's kind of fun, all of this, right? Overlapping infrastructure, all the trees, you got this little, you know, foothill in the background. I love this, right? It just feels so real to me. I don't know. I really like this. I love seeing the CN Tower. Holy smokes. It just kind of catches up on you. Or sneaks up on you, I should say, right? Okay, so a little bit of a rework to some of the rails here to make everything kind of work together. But essentially all of this, this is pretty much brand new, right? And worked in. Maybe you have to put in some more industry through here. But let's see. We're doing pretty well for high volumes of traffic. And then over here, a little bit of change as well. Kind of make things a little bit more compact. A little bit of extension just on some of our industrial areas. And we got our little island over here we just kind of finished making. This is pretty cool. Power plants and, facility kind of area. Some water, you know, and whatnot over here too. Pretty cool. Yeah, this city, guys, like, the opening shot we started with, which I am in love with, is just sunrise. Maybe we can close with that. Just overlooking this part right here. Love this part of the city. So nice. Love is moist. Love is moist. Moist is love. Love can be moist. I guess I can see what you mean there. You guys are a bit of a weirdo. You really are weirdos. I love you all, though. Oh my goodness, so stuffed up. I apologize for being so stuffed up. Like, allergies, they are what they are, you know? Luckily, I don't have too many bad days. Hopefully that fire will go out. But now this right here, this is the shot we opened with when the stream started, and oh my goodness, I love it. I'm taken back by how beautiful this city is, guys. Holy smokes, we built this together! I can't believe it! And it's just over the last few streams, too. This seems to just come out of nowhere. So good job, guys. I think the, oh goodness, Amona Martz? I can't pronounce her name, I'm so sorry. But yeah, thanks for the compliment, I appreciate that. The city does look pretty good. Really liking this. This looks like me. Let me see who this is. Oh, you keep pointing the surface painter. With Surface Painter, I probably will download it. Because you're trying to, like... Oh, you're, oh, wrong link. Okay, I thought you were trying to drop some subtle hints here that I should be downloading that. This spoon... Okay. Jesus. Oh, you guys are so weird. Oh, you guys, you make my night. You make me complete. You only draw... I can do a little heart. Is that... There. You guys make me complete. You guys are so funny. Alright, well, I think that's it, guys. I think we'll end things off here. I really appreciate you sticking with it. Especially for those of you who've been here for the entire stream. Pretty long stream today, so that's good. City is definitely growing. We got ourselves a new city tile, too. So hopefully we can, you know, make things even bigger and better in the next one. Thanks, Christian Carter. Yeah, it's a cool-looking city. It's definitely growing. So let me post the links one more time for you guys. So this is a link to the map, in case you guys want to play along at home. And then this is a link to some of the mods I'm using. Moistropolis is what you call this. You guys, too funny. Too funny. Alright, well, yeah, I'll see you guys later in the week. I don't have a day in mind for when we'll be doing the next stream, but, like, you know, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, who knows? We'll kind of see how the week unfolds. Definitely on Sunday, though, so I'll see you guys, worst case, then. I am going to try and get a lot of content recorded for the YouTube channel. I will be posting this stream to the YouTube channel as well, so feel free to, you know, check on back over there in case you guys tune in later, miss something, or wanted a little refresher on something that we went over. And I'm going to get caught up with the tutorial videos in case you guys are watching those as well. So I've got part 2 already recorded, and that will be coming out either later tonight or early tomorrow. It's going to be the editing. And yeah, otherwise I will see you guys in the next one. Have yourselves a great day. Adios. Hasta vida, Zane. Bonsoir. Arrivederci. I'm trying to think of some more, you know. Some more languages I know. I mean, it might be it. Hasta vida, Zane. That's a good one, too. G-Mux, see you later. Roger, see you later. Nova Dan. Batman, take care. KPD. Is that Paige Patterson? Oh, Paige, I haven't seen you in a while, actually. Christian Carter, too. Thanks for stopping by, guys. Appreciate it all. Guru. So, yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one. So, if you haven't already, definitely hit the subscribe button. Feel free to check out the YouTube channel. I'm making some content there. Follow me on Twitter. I try to keep you guys updated as best I can with news and, you know, funny clips and everything over there. Yeah, simply press start. Out of the lurking. Love it. To all you lurkers, love you all, too. Is that Willoy, Dan the Man, Mona, other Dan? Oh, a lot of Dans here, actually. Thanks, guys. Really appreciate it. I'm really happy to see all you all, you know, coming out every single stream, too. It means a lot to me. Was that Band Thief? See you later. Oh, my goodness. So many of you here. Oh, T-Kane, I'm just about to close things off, but let me give you the link for this map. It is right here. That's a link for the map we're using. And here's a link for some of the mods I'm using as well, just in case you need some of those. But yeah, guys, I will see you in the next one. Take care of yourselves. Thanks for stopping by. All the best. And yeah, happy building. Mwah! Hugs and kisses. You guys are the best. See you in the next one. Take care of yourselves.